All right, so now we're going to get started with more modifiers. 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 So remember what modifiers are, right? They're also called view modifiers, if you will. Modifiers are additional pieces of formatting and functionality that are tacked on to each view, right? They're tacked on. They're right after each view, like resizable and scaled to fit. So we're going to introduce a few modifiers. Let's start by making our name bold. Right, we want to emphasize our name. So I'm going to go over here. And the modifiers can be on the same line as your view, or they can be on different lines. We generally like to have different modifiers on different lines because they kind of line up nicely, right? You can see over here, this modifier. We know that these two modifiers belong to this image. Okay, so I'm going to tap enter. I'm going to say dot bold. And there you go. It's very subtle, but it's certainly become bold. All right. And, you know, in the spirit of Microsoft Word, let's go to make this italic, dot italic, to no one's surprise. That's how you make something italic. And if you want to change the font size, you can do dot font, bracket. And here, you can choose from one of various enums, right? These are default font sizes. You can do dot large title. And this will actually change the entire format of this piece of text into what Apple determines as the best size for a large title for this current device. Notice that the large title format takes over from italic, and that's because Apple has determined that this is the best way for large titles to look on iOS, and you are not going to make it italic. All right. So if you do want to make it a large font size, but with italics, you can go ahead and change this to .font.system. Size 40 or thereabouts, and now you have a bold title with italics with a custom font size. The downside of this is if any of you have tried playing around with the accessibility settings in your iPhone, this piece of text is now stuck at 40 points large. If you were to change the default font size on your phone, this thing is never going to be updated to a bigger font size. And that's just because you're hard coding it to 40. For now, we're fine because I'm pretty happy with a font size of 40. So I'll leave it as it is. You can always change to another size yourself if you like it more. So that's well and good. We've changed the font sizes, right? And you can go ahead and change the font size of this thing down here as well if you'd like. Let's go change the color of our text. So we're going to go change the color of my title text. Let's make it dot foreground color. Notice that you have to spell color like an American. Completely barbaric, right? It should be C-O-L-O-U-R, but that's fine. Foreground color, open bracket. And to choose a color, once again, type dot to choose from a whole bunch of different enums. Let's choose blue. Okay, and there you go. Right, you get a nice blue tint for your title text. You can also give it a background color. This one's slightly confusing. You type dot background, but not dot background color. Okay, just dot background. In the future, we'll show you why it's just dot background. But once again, if you want to put in a color, you can just put dot red. Okay, that's a little ugly. Let's do dot yellow. Okay, that's not so bad. Okay. So, simple enough, right? Again, dot foreground color, color, C-O-L-O-R. I mean, granted, you know, Apple is an American company, so we'll let them have it, but yucks. Dot foreground color, and then dot blue, dot background, dot yellow. So it kind of reads like you are just adding all these different properties, right? You're saying, hey, I want a piece of text, it's got my name in it, I want it to be bold, then I want it to become italic, and I want it to be this font size, and I want to give it this foreground color, and I want to give it this background color. So, nice and sensible way of laying things out. It's almost as though you're just reading out a list of specifications for your user interface, which is what SwiftUI is, right? It's a way of declaring your user interface to the compiler, and it will just say, okay, this is exactly what you want. Now, here's something interesting. We are going to show you one more thing, which is called padding, right? So I want to show you padding. I'm just going to go here. Type dot padding, open bracket, close bracket. And if you look carefully, my text is now indented from all four sides by a certain amount of padding. And that's great. That's great for giving some space between your user interface elements. Now, what I want to do is I'm going to take away this line of padding. All right, I'm going to select the text and press Command X. By the way, if you hold down Command, you'll notice you get a whole bunch of fun little keyboard shortcuts, which we'll talk more about in the future. So I'm going to Command X, and I'm going to put this padding before the background. Let's see what happens. Do you notice the difference? It's very slightly different. Let's show you before and after. So let's do it one more time. So here's what it looked like before. Here's what it looked like after. Now, what you've done is you've said, hey, give this piece of text some space and then color its entire background. So the color now extends to the entire background, including the space that has been given. If I did it this way, though, it means that my text takes up a little bit of space, and then let's give some space around that. Okay, so all these modifiers are applied sequentially, top to bottom. Right, first one, second one, third one, fourth. Some of them don't matter in terms of the sequence. It doesn't really matter whether you do italic first or bold first or font size first, but some of them do, right? When you add a padding first, then add a background, it's going to be different from adding a background than a padding. And if you are so inclined, you can add a padding and a background followed by another padding and a different background color, right? So background.green. Of course, this looks really terrible, so I will spare you from having more of these padding colors. Next, I'm going to show you how to resize some things. So I'm going to go over to my image. I think it's a little bit large. I kind of like having my face nice and big, but I think it could do to be a little bit smaller. So to resize something, you're going to need to change what's called a frame. So that's, again, another modifier. I'm going to type .frame. Open bracket, and inside this frame, you can choose to give it a width or a height. So let's try giving it just a width. If I give it a width of 100, it will scale down so that the width is 100 points big, which is about, you know, whatever size on your iPhone. I don't actually know. Okay, you don't actually need to give it a height parameter because we have this modifier here that says scale to fit, because scale to fit means that we'll make sure that it's nice and proportional. Okay. So this modifier is pretty great in the sense that now your image is always going to be 100 points big, no matter the size of your device. But let's take a look what happens if I expand the preview. All right, it's only 100 points big. So this might or might not be what you want. All right, so just keep this in mind. Whenever you give something a fixed size, like 140, you're not giving it a chance to adapt to the size of the screen. So let me just take this away and let me just demonstrate what it looks like if I had no frame. Right now, my face is nice and gigantic, which makes me happy. So just keep this in mind. It's a bit of a trade-off. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take away this little rectangle over here. I want to make it look, you know, kind of softer, give it a bit of space and everything. I'm going to add what's called a corner radius, rounded corners, right? Those of you who are using, you know, the Apple devices, you know that, you know, all these nice little rounded corners on all your app icons. So I'm going to say dot corner radius. And this is, again, a corner radius is, you know, the radius of a circle, mathematics. So the bigger the number, the more circular it gets. So I'm going to change this to, let's say, 20. So there you go, right? A nice little rounded corner of radius 20. I can change it to slightly bigger, 50. And it becomes this little capsule size thing. And here's something fun. You can change it to dot infinity. And what that does, it just makes it as round as humanly possible, right? So if your picture is of a certain height, right, this thing over here becomes a semicircle. And you generally can't get any rounder than that, okay? You can also give it a padding to make sure that it stays away from the left and right side a little bit. Or you can give it a padding with an argument that says, well, I only want to keep it away from the left side. So I'm going to say padding dot leading, right? Leading in our case is left. Okay. What if I don't want this weird pill shape and I want it to be an actual circle? Well, that's when you use a mask. So I have to wear this to, you know, make sure it's thematic. All right. As you can see, a mask obscures part of your face. And Similarly, the mask modifier in SwiftUI will obscure part of your image. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to replace this with the mask dot mask. And inside the brackets, you get to define what sort of shape lets your image show through. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to say mask circle. That's a simple little shape. And there you go, right? I have a nice little circle which contains my image. You can also choose to put other things inside here. You can mask it with a piece of text if you're so inclined, but the results of that are a little bit harder to work with. In this case, I've masked my image with a tiny letter O. If I were to make it a slightly bigger font size, remember how to do that, dot font, dot system, size 100, right? Then you can kind of see my face inside this letter O. Actually, no, you can't. Let's not do that. And let's go back to a nice little circle. Okay. All right. So that's pretty nice. And we are almost done laying out our screen. I think I would like to remove the leading padding for this right now. And instead, give some trailing padding to my VStack. So you can apply modifiers not just to all the individual views, but also to the container views as well. So I'm going to go to the end of this VStack. How do you know where the end of the VStack is? You can tap on the curly brace, and now you know where the end of the VStack is. So put your cursor right there. Tap on this. Right, be careful not to select too many things. Press enter, and you can do dot padding. And for us, the right side is trailing, so dot trailing. And what that does is it adds a little bit of space at the end of this VStack on the right. And that's it for this section. Thank you for joining us. I hope you learned something new about SwiftUI in this video, but if you didn't, you can watch the next one. So please head over to the next video, and I will see you soon. Soon, because that's me. I'm soon. I've said this at the end of every video. I hope you remember that. Soon.